The app-based game HQ Trivia. Have you heard about this? It is an online sensation with a capital S, just a few months after its release. A hosted game broadcasts live on smartphones. Players from around the world have 10 seconds to tap on the right answer to multiple choice trivia questions. If they get 12 right, they win a share of the prize money. The daily minimum is $2,000, and the prize money has gone as high as $18,000. HQ Trivia broadcasts every night at 9 p.m. Eastern and weekdays at 3 p.m. Eastern. The game has hit a record of more than $1.6 million at the same time that happened
million
the other
players,
night.
Million players, yeah.
What did I say?
Dollars.
Oh, okay. 1.6 million players. Thank you, Norah. The game's host, that's Scott Rogowsky, is here. So is HQ Trivia CEO and co-founder, that's Rus Yusupov. Welcome, 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 guys.
Thank you so much.
I love this game. I discovered it over Christmas holiday with my millennial son and daughter. And when we saw that woman freaking out to hear that she's only winning $11, what is it, Scott, that this makes this game so addictive and so fun?
Well, I mean, beyond the idea of winning money, the chance to win money, which we all love to do,
yes.
I think what HQ Trivia has done is taken the old school idea of a trivia show, a quiz show, which has been around since the dawn of television, even radio, and made it a participatory event versus a spectator sport. Now, it's in your hand, it's in your phone. You don't have to be sitting in front of a TV. You can take it anywhere, play anywhere. And we combined production value and a host and graphics and music and made it a produced experience.
And you're playing in real time, Rus.
Right, playing in real time. My co-founder, Colin, and I, we had created Vine previously and never stopped experimenting since then. We thought, hey, let's combine some of our favorite elements of mobile gaming, live video, and TV production, mash them together and create an experience that people, frankly, have never had before. And HQ Trivia is a game that you play every day at 3 p.m. Eastern, 9 p.m., and it's only 15 minutes. Yeah. Goes live and you answer 12 questions. Scott presents them in a very entertaining and funny way. And if you get them all right, you win or split the cash prize.
What's at the heart of the human response to this? I mean, that response we saw, Gayle is quietly fibrillating over there about this. And what is it, though? I mean, do people like to be smarter than other people? Do they like to be, win?
I think it's a curiosity for knowledge and a desire to learn, right? It also helps bring people together. So we're seeing
all ages, too.
All ages.
That's what's fun about it.
Yeah. You know, for example, Dan Rather, he played with his family at Christmas and welcomed HQ Trivia as a new family tradition where, you know, his grandson and, you know, his family all contributed for the big win. So we're seeing people from 8 to 80 play, and that's really incredible.
And it's the FOMO element, the fear of missing out that's so prevalent in society now. You have to be in it to win it, live at 3 p.m., 9 p.m. Eastern. If you're not there, you can't play.
What's the business model behind this? Because you're currently funding the prize money, but at some point, how will it grow?
That's right. So we are a venture-backed firm, and we do have the flexibility to grow and experiment with the product. And we're hoping to, you know, really hit popular culture before figuring out how to make money. But advertisers and sponsors are reaching out, and we are working on some interesting things on that front. So stay tuned.
But I think the secret sauce are the hosts, and you in particular, Quiz Daddy, which is what he calls himself.
No, I don't know.
Quiz Daddy, Cumero, numero uno is how he starts.
Numero uno.
Yeah. But you're so quick on your feet. You're so witty and so charming. But I'm wondering, is it because of your comedic background how this job came about for you?
Yeah. I mean, I've been doing stand-up since college. Actually, my 13th year anniversary is next week of doing stand-up comedy. Moved to New York after college. I mean, I'm from New York and, you know, did the open mic thing for a while. Started doing my own talk show, which I still do, called Running Late. And after 10 years in New York, I was out in L.A. last year, and I thought maybe L.A.'s the place to be. So I actually gave up my apartment in May, was all set to move, and then HQ came calling. And thankfully, I decided to give it a shot.
Yeah.
Can I ask you a question, Rus, about this? You can't cash out till you win $20, and then you only have 90 days. Why that complexity? Why not I win, I get my money?
So this past Sunday, we saw a record-breaking 1.6 million players in the game, and seven people won, you know, over $2,000 each. So people are winning. It is an attainable prize. Lauren May, she won $11, and it really goes to show, you know, in that reaction video, she was ecstatic. And it goes to show that this is really not so much about the money, it's about the thirst for knowledge and the excitement
and
of winning.
And the pride of it, too.
And it's a hard quiz.
But sometimes there are glitches, guys, which is very frustrating. People get so mean How do you handle that, Scott? And what are we doing about the glitches?
Right.
It's frustrating, Ross, the glitches.
It is unfortunate, but we're paving new ground here. This kind of thing hasn't been done before, and our engineering team is, every day they're working on making the service better, more reliable, and the focus really is on delivering the best possible experience. So you should expect to see it continue to improve.
What does HQ stand for?
We don't have an official.
Yes, it's whatever you want it to be. Hard questions is probably the
toughest
best
quiz question. That one. Yeah.
Hard questions. All right.
Well,
I like
Scott
it.
And Russ, what a pleasure to have both of you two. Continued success.
Thank you. Happy birthday.
So much.
Thank you very much. And I will start playing when the prize money is $1.6 million.
I might get there.